Fresh, pure water is a gift from God above. While man can capture water through rainfall, springs, rivers, lakes, and snowfall melts, he cannot manufacture it. Therefore, how humans use water has a profound effect on all of us, and in particular, on children. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, diarrheal diseases such as cholera kill more children than AIDS, malaria, and measles combined, making it the second leading cause of death among children under the age of 5. In India, abuse of the water supply by humans has caused a water crisis. India is the home to 20% of the world's population and has the largest water withdrawal of any country. However, India contains only 4% of the world's water. Of that water, 86% supports agriculture. The Indus and Ganges rivers are tapped so heavily they rarely reach the sea, and the water tables are dropping fast in many agricultural regions. In spite of the water crisis, people have the power to prevent water pollution and disease from devastating the population. The Salvation Army is partnering with villages to provide clean, unpolluted water to residents, as well as clean sanitation facilities with a strong focus on schools and children's homes. Everyone desires children to be healthy as they learn, yet people who live in poverty have little access to resources and opportunities that we take for granted. Properly maintained water tanks, bore wells, and bathroom facilities at the Salvation Army's schools and children's homes are on site to ensure that children who attend are receiving safe water daily. At the primary school in the village of Sanganeri in the Indian Southeastern Territory, Salvationist volunteers and local workmen partner to replace crumbling unsafe toilets with new, clean facilities for children and teachers. Clean, well-constructed toilets help prevent diseases such as typhoid, hepatitis A, and cholera. Although the facilities are humble, they are effective at eliminating the practice of using fields and roadsides as bathrooms. While the children at the Sanganeri school are primarily Hindu, Christian education is provided daily. By coming alongside families with excellent teaching in a healthy and safe environment, the water of life is being poured out to thousands of children each day. Please keep these children and the Salvation Army in India in your prayers as eternal work is underway. Your sacrificial giving to world services is making the difference. Thank you. To him who is...
I invite the ushers to come forward to receive our tithes and offerings. Psalm 96, verse 3, reminds us that we are to declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples. Every day in 131 countries worldwide, you will find the Salvation Army doing just that, proclaiming the word of God and sharing the life-changing news that Jesus saves. And every day, God is using the ministry of the Salvation Army to respond to human need in his name, changing the world by extending Christ's love, offering compassion, providing opportunity, and giving hope. We are all called to make a difference in the world by sharing God's love with all people. Next Sunday, we will have opportunity to partner in global ministry during the World Services in Gathering. At that time, we will present our special Easter World Services offerings, along with the coin canisters that we've been filling. Thank you for your prayerful, sacrificial support of World Services. Thank you, too, for your faithful giving of tithes and offerings throughout the year. Let's pray. Father God, thank you for your great love for each one of us. Help us to live out the good news of Jesus and have a heart for others. Accept and bless our tithes and offerings and use them for your kingdom. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.